Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2065, a formula for progressive tax rates. All right, so I got this comment on YouTube from Asad, who is trying to come up with a formula that will calculate his income tax. He says he has an income tax statement that he downloaded from office.com. I just made a quick little one here with income and income year to date going across. And we're trying to figure out the tax for this. All right, so to get started, the first thing we have to do is take Asad's income tax card and build a little table somewhere out of the way, right? So I just decided to come down here. I might go over to column, you know, Z or something like that. And you take this information and you convert it into a table with three columns, all right? So if you're at $0, you pay zero tax and 0% of any amount over zero. But once you hit 400,000, then you're paying 7% of the amount over 400,000. At 500,000, you're paying $7,000 plus 10% of the amount over $5,000. So this lookup table here is going to become crucial towards solving the problem. All right, well, hey, let's just dive in straight away and do this. So we're going to use a function called VLOOKUP, and I use VLOOKUP a lot, the other version, the exact match version. But in this case, we're going to use the what they call the approximate match version. So we go look for this amount, 249,351, in this table, and I'll press F4 there to lock that table down. In other words, put the dollar signs in, and then what I want is I want the base tax rate. So that's the second column, and then comma true. You can leave the true out, but I always put the true in, just that way I know that it's there. All right, and see that's coming up with just this amount, the 7,000, the 32,000. If I copy it across, you'll see how that part is working. That certainly isn't the whole formula. I just wanted to show what that one piece is doing. And I'm going to be very clever here and copy the formula, except for the equal sign. So select it, because I'm going to reuse that formula over and over and over again. So in addition to that, we have to use the percentage, all right, and the percentage is over in column 3 of the table. So right there is the percentage. The percentage of the amount in B16 that is greater than the amount in column 1 of the table. So times in parentheses B16 minus, and again we're going to put another VLOOKUP in there. This time is using table column number 1. All right, and there's our formula. We'll copy that formula across like that. All right, and that should be the right answer. Although, you know, I realize that's probably a pretty complicated formula, and if this is something really important, you know, like homework, then you would want to at least do some checks to make sure that it's going to work. All right, so I paused the video there, and here's my set of check formulas. Basically, just breaking down this formula that has, well, 1, 2, 3, 4 components, and doing it one at a time. So here is the base rate using VLOOKUP comma 2. Here's the percentage using VLOOKUP comma 3. Here's the initial amount using VLOOKUP comma 1, and then calculating the amount over, that would be this amount, 100, the income up there in M16 minus the base, doing the calculation of the percentage, 15% times that amount, and then finally just a simple addition to add the tax. And so hopefully all of these formulas are going to match those formulas. We can put a little formula here where we say, is the result of all those smaller formulas equal to the one big formula? What we're hoping to get there is all trues all the way across, and sure enough, that works. So at that point, we know that our big formula up there is working. Now, the problem is with this is that we have that table sitting off to the side, and if you're looking for a single formula to do this, it would be possible to do that. So I'm going to do one formula. Check out this cool trick, Ctrl and the quotation mark, I guess Ctrl apostrophe really, brings the formula down, doesn't change any of the references, and leaves the formula in edit mode. And what I can do here is click right there, and press the F9 key. That'll embed that table right in the formula. And then here, this lookup table, choose those characters, press the F9 key, And finally here, select the lookup table one more time and press the F9 key, and we get one monster formula that will do everything without having the lookup table in the workbook. Asad, if this actually is homework for you, just go ahead and turn that one in, and it'll make your professor's head spin. You'll probably, you know, get high marks for the exercise. All right. Hey, to learn all sorts of formulas about Excel, check out my new book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel, the 2017 edition. It includes some Power BI and Power Query and things like that. Wrap up of this episode, we tried to create a formula to create a progressive tax rate. The most important thing is to set up that table in ascending order with the amounts from your income tax card, three columns. You'll do three approximate match VLOOKUPs to get the base tax, the percentage, and the start of the level. You subtract that start level from the income for the period, multiply by the percentage, and then add the base. Then near the end there, use Ctrl, I call this Ctrl Ditto, Ctrl Apostrophe to copy a formula down one cell without changing the references, and leave it in edit mode. And then finally, the F9 trick from Mike Girvin, Excel is fun, to embed the lookup table into the formula. All right, I want to thank Asad for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.